Hello everyone and welcome back to another Swedish lesson with lexicon tutorials. I have been thinking a lot of what to include in today's lesson, and I don't know how about you, but I think it's important that I teach you things that you can start to use immediately. So I won't give you a large vocabulary or sort of teach you the names of the fruits, because you don't have the grammar yet to talk about fruits or things like that. But I think one thing that is a very important foundation to build the Swedish language upon is some knowledge about the pronunciation and spelling system. So my aim today is to give you the tools so that you can decipher a written Swedish word and understand how it's pronounced. And in Swedish orthography, it isn't that one-to-one match that you could sometimes wish for, but it's fairly phonetically written, so if you just apply a few simple rules, you will be able to make yourself a pretty clear idea of how the word is pronounced. So that is the rules that I'm going to teach you today, and there are exceptions of course, but you will often be able to understand how it's pronounced. We are going to go through all the different sounds, all single phonemes of the Swedish language. So whatever word you encounter on your journey through the Swedish language, you'll be prepared to meet that, because you have already dealt with all the single phonemes that it consists of. I will use the phonetical signs to represent the sounds, and some of you maybe think that these are just confusing and scary and intimidating, and if you find them confusing, just close your eyes and listen to the sounds instead. And if you find them helpful, then don't close your eyes. I will then later on, when you have repeated that part of this video until you are sure on the sounds, then we are going to proceed to the spelling system and when these different sounds are made, which letter combinations represent which sounds, so that you will be able to read words. So that is the plans for today. So I'm starting with the phonemes. So here comes the vowel sounds, and listen carefully. E. E. U. E. A. O. O. U. I. I. U. E. B. T. D. K. G. U. D. T. L. first rule that I'm going to give you is the sort of the same as in English, I guess, and other Indo-European languages, that if you have a double-spelled consonant, the vowel sound before that becomes short. So now we are going to go through some long and short vowel sound, vowel sounds, and see what sound, which phonetical symbol and sound represents what letter, and yes, whether it's short or long, and some common exceptions from the rule. Sometimes there's two alternative pronunciations for the same spelling. You will hear a lot of words today, but today we are going to have a 100% focus on pronunciation, and I don't even have the time to translate all the words for you, so you can just ignore the words and think about the pronunciation instead. So here we have tak, the shorter A sound in this word, tak, so you can compare them, tak, tak. And now we do the same for the letter E, and here, sed, it becomes the long E sound like that, sed, sed. And if we do it short, if we put 2D after it, it becomes sed, which represents this sound, sed, sed. And now let's have an exception from this rule to make it a little more interesting. If you see this word, herre, it becomes the short ä sound instead, herre. And then we do the same for letter I. If it's long, it becomes I, sid. And if it's short, it becomes I, sit, sid, sit. Then we have the ä sound. And if we have it long, it becomes ä, kär. If it's short, it becomes, in most cases, kär. I think it's in most cases, this sound. Like, and then we have an exception that is in red. Hell. Then we have this letter U, which always becomes like this. And I don't think it has any exceptions. Tur. And we take the short one. Tull, which always becomes like this. Tur, tull. And then we have letter Y, and you can be pretty sure about that as well, because I couldn't find any exceptions. Syl, syl, this phoneme. And then we have mylla, syl, mylla. So, this is the letter O, and it often becomes like this. Tor, and that is the option that you should go for if you see a word with this letter and want to pronounce it tor. And then we have some exceptions from that, which is pronounced more like å, lova. Tor, lova. And then we have the two sort of rule and exception pair for the short as well. So this is the more common, I think so at least. It can be this, but it's either. If you read a word, it's either. Torr, butt. So this is like, oh, torr, and this is more, oh, butt. And we can take, å, tår, tår, sol. And let's take some ö, hög. And then we have an exception when it's before an R. Hög, mör. And then we have the short, which is similar for both. Kött, which is always like this. Hög, mör, kött. Yes, and now we're going to go through another important thing that you have to know in order to pronounce Swedish words that you read, and that is the hard and the soft vowels. And you have them here. You can see the hard ones are A, O, U and O, and the soft ones are E or E, I, Y, A and E. And these are important to know because they determine how the G, the letter G, the letter K and the combination SK are pronounced when it's before one of these letters. So if we read them, all of them. Gata, god, gud, gå. Get, gick, gyllen, jälar, göl. Katt, kon, kul, kor. Kemi, kil, kyl, känd, köl. Skatt, sko, skur, skåp. Sked, skick, sky, känd, skön. Now we are going to go some other consonant combinations and see when they sound together and becomes one sound and what sound. I'm starting up with some different ways to spell this weird sound. So sjö, it can be spelled sj. So when you see sj, it's always like this. Sjö. Skjuta. Stjärna. Skidor. Now we have some ways to, or some, one way to spell this sound. And you remember this sound is also the sound that becomes when a K is before a soft vowel. So kemi, kil, kyl, känd, köl. And it has another way of, if you see a T and a J like this, you can be pretty sure it is the very same sound again. Tjuv. Tjuv. Now I'm going to tell you about some different combinations that always sound like J. And a normal J, of course, also sound like J. But here we have some other J-sounding combinations. H-J sounds like J. Hjärta. Hjärta, you can't hear an H. D-J sounds like J. Djup. L-J sounds like J. Ljuv. G, J, sounds like J, gjorde. And then, of course, G before a soft vowel sounds like J, and J sounds like J. And then, G after an R sounds like J, berg. And last but not least, J after an L sounds like J, älg. Now we can look at how some letter combinations sound in the end of words, sort of pang. This is the same as in English, pang, and it's sort of this dark ng sound, and it's barn. In this word, in all words where an R and an S is sounding together in the end of the word, it's or in the middle of the word, or anywhere in the word, then it's like sh, mash, mash. I'll see you soon in my next video, so goodbye, hej då.